Howdy folks, Matt here with Gulf Coast Fit. Run through a back attack circuit today. It's a circuit because it's five exercises. When it's more than four exercises, that is what constitutes a circuit. Four exercises is a giant set. Three exercises is a tri-set. Two exercises is a superset. And then there are straight sets or conventional sets. So doing five back exercises, back to back to back to back to back, focusing on different angles and different mechanics of your back. I'll be doing variations of exercises in the gym here that focus more on the back, the lats primarily, and less on the biceps. So you're going to see me doing variations of different back exercises that don't put a lot of emphasis on the biceps like a lot of back exercises tend to. So you're not going to see any narrow grip exercises that have a lot of elbow extension and flexion. It's going to be mid to wide grip on most everything. And what I'm going to do is switch off between a vertical pulling exercise with a horizontal pulling exercise. I'm going to go back to what I consider a vertical pull and then back to another horizontal pull. And then we'll finish with a smaller kind of isolation type burnout exercise. So on all of these lifts, we want to focus on, since this is a hypertrophy circuit, we want to focus on 8 to 12 reps. That's kind of your sweet spot. Really 10 to 12 is the sweet spot. But at any given time, you know, you've got to compromise as needed. And it's okay if you go down to as little as 8 reps or up to, I would say, 15 reps. So 8 to 15 is kind of a broad target. But if you want to hit that bullseye, then 10 to 12 is really what we're shooting for on anything. So this is my third time through this out of 5 rounds. I'm taking a good 3, 4, 5 minutes rest between each round because I'm really going all out, not necessarily as heavy as possible, but I'm trying to get the best quality reps and the best quality sets out of each of these lifts. And I'm resting about 45 seconds to a minute between each set, because if you're doing 8 to 12 or whatever, 10 to 12 reps in a manner where the intensity is right where you need to have it for hypertrophy, then you're going to need adequate recovery. Not full recovery, but up to a minute. So without further ado, we're going to start right here on the wide grip. This is a wide neutral grip lat pull down. And I've adjusted my weight a little bit here. Emphasis on the lats, the stretch, and the squeeze at the bottom. I had to add an extra rep in there. I needed 13 to hit the money there. And I want you to notice that, or realize that, that's a weight that, if we're not focusing on stretching and lengthening, contracting and squeezing, and making the most out of every rep, that would not have been a very challenging weight for me to do 8, 10, 15 times. I could probably do it really fast, 30 times. But it's about the contraction, the control, and that's what contributes to the intensity of the lift. Normally intensity refers to how much weight you're moving, but in this scenario intensity refers to how well you're contracting your muscles. Going on to our horizontal pull. We've got a semi-wide grip cable row here. And a good weight here. Here we go. I wouldn't call this wide grip. Definitely not a narrow grip. I just call it a semi-wide grip.
Oh,
I actually hit 15 there because I wanted to add in a few reps after the 12. Just a little body English, a few cheat reps, which I feel is very appropriate on something like cable rows if you're doing it intentionally and under control. Swing right over here. Try to keep these guys out of the gym. Third lift, we are moving on to something that I consider a vertical pulling exercise. Some people don't, but I do. And that's a dumbbell lat pullover. I've never been a huge proponent of dumbbell lat pullovers because they're a little bit risky on shoulder impingement overhead, especially for someone like me who's in the tight shoulder club. But since I've been neglecting dumbbell lat pullovers for most of my lifting career, it is a weakness and it's something I need to address. So, working with a weight here, maybe this is 60 pounds, something that I know is easily manageable for me and that I must focus on the stretch, the control, and the contraction without going heavy, again, because reaching up and overhead, for me, that's just kind of a gray area, shoulder impingement, and that's just really me being proactive about injury prevention and not risking shoulder injury. So I'm going knees up, feet on the bench. Reduces the stress on your lower back. So it helps you engage your lats more effectively. Again, I cut it short at 12 there. Could have done more, but erring on the side of caution and injury prevention. Not a fan of heavy lat pullovers, but it is a good movement pattern. You don't want to avoid any movement pattern. All right, this way. Come back to our horizontal rowing movement pattern. We got a good old-fashioned T-bar row here. I'm going to opt for the wide grip instead of the neutral grip because that's less biceps and more lats when you're out here. I saved this is our final big exercise. I saved the T-bar row for our fourth exercise because towards the end of the five exercise circuit, and now's the time where you kind of push it to the point where you're burning out or maybe hitting failure. This is a safe machine to hit failure on. It's the worst thing that can happen. You let the weight go. You're gonna see an increased tempo here because this is a good burnout exercise. Generally, a little faster. Five more. Machines like this are good for. Hop right back in the saddle, squeeze that RTI. Three and a half. Perfect rest pause. Alright, final exercise is our smallest, weakest exercise. a reverse fly or a rear delt fly.
I don't know how that would work out.
Not particularly heavy on this as well, but now I'm gonna do another, probably another rest pause, aiming for that 15 rep range. Cumulatively, 15 reps. Set on the fly. I think I love that about the scene. Quick drop set. Keep moving. Nice little cluster set there. I'll take this. Thank you much. Now there you have it. A 5 lift back circuit. And what I did was prioritize. For me, I prioritized what exercises I wanted to do first and the best, and finish with the exercises that were safest to do under fatigue. So give that a go. You don't have to do these exact exercises if you don't have these exact machines. Just do movement patterns. Pick 5 back exercises in a row. Hit 8 to 12, 10 to 12 reps, about a minute between each, 4 or 5 rounds. Feel the back pump. Can't have too strong of a back, remember that. Have fun, stay strong.